Hello YouTube. Well, you can see here, got a piece of railroad iron that I've had for close to 30 years. And I am going to take some of it and create, or try to create, an anvil of sorts. So, as the process goes, I'm going to try to actually do a double stacked one, side by side anyways. So as I progress with this, I'll do some video and try to capture some of it and see what you think. Okay guys, here's what I've got. Got two pieces, cut them off, 24 inches long. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this web off on both sides so I can bring these two together. And then because these are the wear side of the track, I'm going to be welding down the center. Now I know what you're saying, I'm probably going to take the temper and everything out. Well, it's not really a big issue because there is a lot of radius there and I could always hard surface it. But what I plan on doing is once I shape the horn, I'll also be getting some hard plate to put on top. So I'll have a build-up surface and then it'll step at the horn and then the horn will come out. So that's the progress so far, and as I move on a little bit more, I'll show you some more. Alright, here we go. Well, I've got them, my two pieces cut the length, and got the web piece cut off so I can put them right together. So now I'm getting ready to make this relief cut on the back, and this cut out here on this end for the horn. When I get done with it, I'll show you what it looks like. Okay. As you can see, got it cut out for the horn and a relief cut on the end. So now I just have to decide how I'm going to make this cut here, because I don't want to grind on it for days and days and days. So it may be a compound torch cut, I'm not sure, but I'll give you an update when I get done. Okay, here's another little update. Welding off the bottom, of course, in this channel groove, I just used a really deep penetrating rod, kind of V'd it out just a little bit. And then over on this section, I used some 7018 to cap it over. And pretty easy rod to use. And I'll do a stitch, and then I'll show you what happens to the flux on it if everything's right. So unfortunately I can't show you why I'm welding because I don't have anybody to hold the camera, and of course you wouldn't see anything anyway except for a big flash. So I'll just show you when I get done. Okay, here's the beauty of using 7018. It cleans up wonderful. As you can see, or maybe you can't see, the flux is already peeling off and it just kind of pops right off. So yeah, it's a real nice rod to use. Back in my welding days in college, we always referred to this as idiot rod because it was pretty easy to weld with. but it is a strong weld, so. Okay, here's another update. As you can see, I've got the two halves joined together. Now I'll finish welding this off with some hard surfacing rod. And I still plan on putting a plate on top of this, a hardened plate from here to down to here. And then I put me a little hardy hole in here. But I will say that if you have any desire to make one of these, plan on doing lots of grinding. And this stuff is hard, extremely hard. Beneficial to have a torch. And of course, I get a little carried away with the torch, but that'll all come out of there by the time it's all said and done. So, lots of shaping to go. So, as I progress, I'll give you another update.